Hi, Nancy here. Got my tank set up today and just kind of doing a dry run with it. And I thought that I would just run you through my quick setup. So this year I'm using a file cabinet again. I have a drawer on the top so I can put my salmon things in. I line the top of it with a piece of plastic. Then I have my chiller set up underneath this chair that I found. And then I'm running my Cascade 1200 on top. And then I've installed a little shelf over here where I have my plugs. And I went ahead and labeled all of my plugs so that you know what they are, so you don't have to pull out the wrong plug if you don't need to. And then I have my air set up, and I have two ports. So the chiller is underneath this chair. I still have easy access to clean the air screen, and then in the back you can see there's the hookups, and that's where you have to put some clamps on there. And then in the back, when I set this up, I wanted to make sure that I still had a little space between the wall and the filter so I can easily take off the top. So let's go ahead and look inside. And the way I have it set up is I am using gravel and some fist-size rocks. I've made some little piles. And I really only have maybe an inch of gravel. This is the larger size gravel, so you really don't have to use a whole lot. This is like less than 10 pounds, I believe. And I've just kind of spread it out. It will act as a bed for the eggs and something for the alvin to hide in. And then later on, when the salmon become fry, I will actually remove all of this gravel, but leave the large rocks in. They will still provide some beneficial space for the bacteria to grow on. All right, so let's go inside. And the way I have this set up is on the left side. This is the outflow of my Cascade filter. And then on the other side, this is the inflow. So this is where I'm taking water into the filter. Set it up. I've attached some suction cups so it will stay in place. So I have the outflow and inflow on different ends of the tank to kind of aid with the circulation. Also, on this left side is the chiller pump, and it's hiding down in the bottom. But what I had to make sure, and I have it hiding behind this plastic plant just for aesthetics, I have to make sure is that you can lift your pump out easily so you can access the screen that's in here and be able to clean it. So when you're installing these, you want to make sure that that happens. All right, as I was monkeying around, the little filter came off. So these are the filters that I would like you guys to start putting on the Aqua Clears. What happens is at the base where the Aqua Clear comes in, these slots are too large for our little pinhead alvins, and they actually will get sucked in there and they will end up in your filter, and you will not even know that you've lost like 10 or more, sometimes even more. And so what we're doing is we're now installing these pre-filters. at the base of the Aqua Clear. Then it also allows you some more sponge area for your bacteria. Let's see, the other thing I've done is I'm using these little suction cups for my air hose, and I can just squeeze it on there and it'll help it stay. So the other thing is I actually have my pump sitting on top of a large rock. I don't want my pump on the bottom of where the alvin can get stuck underneath, things like that. So I want to be able to set it up on something. So this is the inflow of the chiller, this pipe, and then on the other side is the outflow for the chiller. And for my other air, so I'm using a sponge filter on this side, and it has an air stone on the inside, and that allows me to be able to change out my other filter material while still keeping this whole sponge area accessible to the beneficial bacteria. So it has an inside basket. And then it has a little air stone in there. So this is all in the tube. So, and then my other air is actually coming down, and you can see in the bottom that I have a, what it's called, a bubble wall underneath, and this will still allow air to come up and bubble through everything. So on the top, I have an Aqua Clear 110. And I will show you how I have it stacked. So here's your beneficial bacteria material, your ceramic stones, and then underneath that I have a bag of charcoal or carbon, and I buy bulk and then just refill these. And when you put new stuff in here, please rinse it really good, and get that carbon dust off of there. And then in the bottom is the sponge, and you can just grab these two pieces together and then put it down in, and that makes it a lot easier to get in here. That everything is nice and even, and I'm actually going to put a little bit more material in there for beneficial bacteria to grow on. When you're setting these up, make sure that this little nipple is on the inside as all these pieces come apart. So when you're cleaning, when you put these back together, make sure the nipple is in here. I'll show you what that is for. And the top here, you can adjust the flow. So right here is a plus, and this is a minus, and this moves back and forth. And so you can adjust your flow. And then when you're putting these together, go ahead and before you start these, because you never want to run these dry, go ahead and put a lot of water in here. And I like having a plastic cup around. You can just come in here, grab some water, and then pour some water in here before you turn it on, put any electricity to it. All right, let's go down into the Cascade filter. So some of you will have the 1000 model. This is the 1200 model. It has four baskets, and the other one has three baskets. So way this works is it has an in and an out. And on the top, let's see, I don't know if you can see it. This says in, and over here it says out. So the in has blue. So blue, blue, and actually on here is also blue. So that tells you that this is the in, and then this is the out. So these have a valve. This is closed. This is open. So the way I like to set these up is I like having two buckets available. So I have one close by here, and this allows me to come over here, turn these off, pull out my electricity. I'm going to have these in the off position, and that allows me to keep these on here. You don't have to take these off. The other way you can do it is you do take these off, put these in your bucket nearby, and then take the head and the canister with you to the sink. Oh, and the other thing is I have a plastic tub underneath this one, because when you take these caps off, you will leak a little bit. So the way I have it set up here is I'm actually going to unclip it and then put it in a nearby bucket. There we go. All right, so I have that safely in a nearby bucket, and that will be dripping. And then now you have access to all of your baskets. So then you want to take another bucket, and then you can start removing your baskets. So you have a top screen, and I want to show you that this top screen has these little edges, and that goes up. So those little edges will go up, not down. But you can start putting all of your stuff in your buckets. So your top basket is going to have your beneficial bacteria balls, your ceramic media, whatever you're using. Then your second basket normally would have some sort of charcoal carbon in here. You can use it with your zeolite packs. And again, I buy in bulk, and I just refill these, put a zip tie on there, and then I'm good to go. I've used some filter material to take up some space around the hole. Then the third basket down. They both want to come out. Is some more filter material. And it's just polishing, two separate types of polishing fabric. Again, these can be taken out and rinsed in a tank. A bucket of tank water. So that's the third basket. The fourth basket is more polishing material, but also you have a sponge, a coarse sponge in the bottom. So this is where all of the poop is going to get, is right on the bottom there. And again, these pads can be rinsed out like once a month. The difference between the 1000 and the 1200 model is that you can have this other material, these pre-filter stones that catch a lot of the debris. When you start putting these back in, make sure that they are not sitting up on anything. And you want to make sure that these are lining up correctly. Make sure that you don't have the space. You want it nice and close. So we'll just go in here and readjust this. You always want to again put water, fill these up, put water in here, tank water. After you've treated it, go ahead and put tank water in here until it's right up to the top right here. Now when you put these back on, so let's look at the bottom side of here. Here is the propeller over here, and this is where you're going to unscrew this about once a year and take out the propeller and clean that with your finger and then carefully reinsert it. But on this side, this is where the water is forced back up in through here. And so this little piece here, you want to make sure that you always have this, and it has two different sides. You have this side and you have that side, and they look completely different. You can see that. So this side, the thinner side, goes down on top here. And it just sits on there like that. Okay, and this goes down on top. So when you put the lids back on, you want to make sure that your baskets are all lined up and that there's no space in between them and that there's no space right here before you start clicking these on. And then it's just click, 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 click. All right. So we want to make sure that there is no gaps here before you plug this in or start it up. And no forcing. These things are just plastic. No forcing. Okay. When I do my maintenance, I am using this kit. It's a no spill kit. It allows me to put this on the sink and then it drains out and goes into the sink. On the other end, I have a shut off. That allows me to clamp it on my tank. Now my water can just flow in here. I don't have to worry about it. And what is this? So what I did is I figured out that this cap fits on the end of the tube. And this allows so this alvin will not be sucked up in there, but I can collect all the poop and grossness that's in the tank. So it was great. So all I did was I took a cap and I took off the inside and then I just drilled a bunch of holes. And then you just stick it right on the top. All right. Well, hopefully this has helped you with your setup and taking care of your filters. Let me know if you have any comments about it. Thanks. So I'm filling this using the Python no spill unit that attaches to a sink. This is a 25 foot unit going from a bathroom to a bedroom. So yeah, works great. The sponge filter is floating at this point. You just need to squeeze it, get some water in, and then it will sink to the bottom. At this point, I'm going to stop and check my air to see if it's good. So here I've turned the air on and you can see my bubble wall. It was made by that blue piece that we saw earlier. And then there is the sponge filter at work. And the air is just pulled through it. And then it bubbles out the top. So I just filled up the Aqua Clear. And what you want is you want it just flowing over the top, and that's called priming it before you plug it in. You can hear that sound. That's normal little burping. And all that air is going to clear. Push this down if you have to. And maybe add a little bit more water. You go. That's what you want. You want that nice flow out of your filter. Okay, so what we have so far is we have the air going and the Aqua Clear. So I went ahead and filled the tank to the full line. And what I've done is on my tank, I just put a little piece of tape, and it just says full, and this one says 1/3. Then I can easily just figure out, okay, when I want to do a water change, I want to go from here down to here, but not any farther. You don't want to go past 1/3 of a change. And so when I start up, I'm not just going to use tap water to fill my filter chambers. I went ahead and treated the whole tank for the tap water, and then I used a pitcher to fill both the Aqua Clear and my other Cascade filter. And I filled this one to right here. Then it's less air and less water that I have to push through here. So now we're going to click it down. And make sure your valves are open. And we're going to push the water through. So I have plugged in my chiller pump, which, if you remember, is hiding back there behind the plant. And then the outflow is right here. So I want to make sure that I put my hand in here and I see good flow bubbling up on my hand. So now that has been going for about 20 minutes now. So we are going to plug in our chiller. And I can't emphasize enough about having towels and extra plastic things around to help you when you do maintenance or have to get in this filter, which I just had to do. And I am so glad that I had this plastic container underneath. See all this water? All right, so we are down with our chiller. And you can see that the green light is blinking, which means you're in cooling. And to set this, I would press on here until it starts flashing, and then I'm gonna go down. I want it at 48 right now. It's flashing now. It's set. So right now my water I just put in is 54 degrees 54 and a half, and so it is on cooling, and it should start kicking in here any moment. It is on a 2-minute delay. Alright, so that is the setup. Have a great year. Wanted to mention a few things about getting your tank to cycle. So we ask that you set them up about a month ahead of time so that the tanks can cycle. What that means is you want them to do a big ammonia spike and then have the beneficial bacteria get started so that it can eat the ammonia, turn into nitrite, and then finally the nitrate will eat the nitrite. and you will have your tanks start cycling. So in order to kickstart the cycle, you can you need to build up the ammonia in the tank. One way is to stick a piece of fresh fish in your tank, and you can float it in the bottom or stick it in a bag. This year I am going to try old food. So I have stuck some food in this bag, putting it in the flow of the filter water, and I'm gonna see if I can get my ammonia to spike over the next week with that in there. And then if it does spike, I'm going to start treating the water with stability, and what that will do is help rapidly establish the biofilter and what you want to do with that. And you just want to read the directions on here. And it says, for introducing any time, where is it, new aquariums. And then you just use a capful per day for 7 days to get that filter established. Once your ammonia spikes, go ahead and pull out your yucky fish or the food or whatever you have. Start adding your beneficial bacteria, and you should be able to get your cycle started. If you are going to use a hood that has a light in it, just make sure that you aren't running it for very long each day. The salmon really do not like extra light. So if you're just using it to do some filming for a few minutes or just looking at the tank, that is fine. But other than that, you should try to keep your tank as dark as possible. All right.